Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we're going to be answering a question from Mirwest, who asks, "Hi, I'm working on a desk for my office that has a series of faceted faces. Any tutorials on how to do this that would create a desk that can be easily imported later down the road into Revit? It will be made into an actual constructed item, similar to the picture I attached. Thanks." I've gone and I've imported the image that was attached to that into Sketchup. I'm not doing a photo match here because there's not really much to match, but there are a few different things that I want to tackle that are a part of this question. And the first is that Sketchup can't handle things that are going to be actually constructed, that it's more of a conceptual based program. And I would say that that's not true. There are a ton of people doing all of their drawings just using SketchUp. So don't dismiss SketchUp just as simply a concept program, that you can actually use it for all of your drawings, especially if you have SketchUp Pro and are exporting to layout. So there's that. And then the second thing is that importing to Revit, you can certainly do. It's been a long time since I've used Revit, but from what I remember, you import from SketchUp as a mass, and then you can edit that mass a little bit. You can like turn into a curtain wall. That's going back many, many years. And it could have changed since then. But basically, my suggestion is try to minimize the amount of software that you're going between. So in this case, you want to go from SketchUp, you want to do something in SketchUp and then put it in Revit. And I would say this is completely possible to do entirely in Revit and entirely in SketchUp. So I would say pick one, because you're not really gaining anything by using SketchUp as a crutch in this instance, because it would be easier to model in SketchUp. So actually in this model, SketchUp is so incredibly suited to this desk that it's pretty crazy. So the way that SketchUp works is that it makes faces, and this is just all a bunch of faces. The only way that you can make a face in SketchUp is by using triangles. So basically anything we draw is gonna be able to turn into this desk. So I'm just gonna sort of rough some things out first. Just make like this front, what I think the front might look like. So there's like a triangle thing there. Let's say this goes straight back. And then bring this up. And this is gonna be like completely out of scale. So let's say we got something like that. Let's make this, and then we're gonna hit the move tool, lock to the green axis and hold the left arrow so that we can move that. And then let's say there's a triangle here. What does the top look like? Let's say something like, I'm just totally guessing here. So that, let's say that's our top, and then let's say we want this to be flat, right? So I'm just using the move, L for line, M for move, and moving all of these points to get something that I think is similar to what this is. I'm gonna make a vertical line here and then attach it. So we have like that thing. Looks like this comes all the way across. So let's choose this intersection, connect that, right? Do that, and then connect from this to this, and it should make those. Now you can see that there's actually two separate colors here, and maybe it's a little bit hard to tell when you've been working in SketchUp a lot. You can tell when they're different colors, especially if you're using a different style. They actually show up purple, but these are gray, or I've heard some people say blue, and then there are white faces. You want them to be all the same color, especially if you're rendering, because it can mess with the software or if you start applying materials. So I'm just going to right click all of those and do reverse faces. So that's what we have there. And this actually looks super bizarre. Super bizarre. Let's do that. It looks okay. Then I actually don't need this line. We'll connect this. And there we go. So it's not exactly, obviously you could mess with this a whole lot more and study what it actually looks like, but this is like the general feel of maybe what it looks like. And you get some, we don't need this line, or we shouldn't. So I guess there's some geometry that isn't flat. So if you want the whole top to be flat, you would just select your points here, make sure they're all in the same plane. And then you should eventually be able to erase that line like that. So, yeah, hopefully this helped. It's kind of a weird looking thing. You can obviously massage it, selecting the move tool and then the arrow keys to lock in direction. You know, let's say, you know, I'm not really a big fan for this line. Well, let's make it here. That'll make two different triangles. And maybe I don't want that. I'll just push this side in. And you can just mess around in that way. Maybe this sticks out because nobody's worried about your hips. This gives you a general idea of what you can do with SketchUp, and you could save this and import it into Revit. But again, I would just recommend don't do that if you don't have to. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to smash that like button. Whoops. Or your table. Subscribe and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.